Canine distemper is extremely contagious viral disease which is actually transmitted through airborne exposure. Diseases affect pups of all ages and breeds in every state. Since dogs can catch these diseases at dog's park, groomers or shelter, it's really very important to always keep a watchful eye on your pup. Today, in this video, we're going to talk about what is canine distemper, how is canine distemper spread, what dogs are at risk, what are the symptoms of canine distemper, how canine distemper is treated, how is canine distemper prevented. Hey guys, welcome to the Puppedia. Before we begin today's video, make sure to subscribe our channel to know the facts and knowledge about your dog. Everybody in the world loves dogs. They are like kids, even they can get sick anywhere. And in order to keep them around as long as possible, it's very important to know which diseases are prevalent in dogs, what symptoms to look for, and how to prevent your pup from contracting them. As mentioned, today we're going to talk about canine distemper. If you guys are ready, then let's get started. Number 1. What is canine distemper? Canine distemper is a contagious and serious disease caused by a virus that attacks the respiratory and nervous system of the puppies and dogs. It is sometimes called hard pad disease because it hardens dogs' nose and foot pads. It is actually transmitted through airborne exposure or the contacts like shared football. This disease predominantly affects puppies and dogs that are especially prone to airborne viruses. Now coming to airborne, these are bacteria or viruses that are most commonly transmitted through small respiratory droplets. The virus can also be found in wildlife such as foxes, wolves, coyotes, raccoons, skunks, mink and ferrets, and has been reported in lions, tigers, leopards and other wild cats as well as seals. Number 2. How is canine distemper spread? Pups and dogs most often become infected through airborne exposure to the virus from an infected dog or wild animal. The virus can also be transmitted by shared food and water bowls and equipment. Infected dogs can shed the virus for months, and mother dogs can pass the virus to the placenta to their puppies. Because canine distemper also impacts wildlife population, contact between wild animals and domestic dogs can facilitate the spread of the virus. Canine distemper outbreaks in local raccoon populations can signal increased risk for pet dogs in the area. Number 3. What dogs are at risk? Almost all the dogs are at risk, but pups younger than 4 months old and dogs that have not been vaccinated against canine distemper are at increased risk of acquiring this disease. Number 4. What are the symptoms of canine distemper? AVMA, American Veterinary Medical Association, describes that initially infected dog will develop watery to pus-like discharge from their eyes, then they develop fever, nasal discharge, coughing, lethargy, reduced appetite and vomiting. As the virus attacks the nervous system, infected dogs develop circling behavior, head tilt, muzzle twitches. Virus may also cause the foot pad to thicken and harden, leading to its nickname called hard pad disease. In wildlife, infection with canine distemper closely resembles rabies. Distemper is often fatal, and dogs that survive usually have permanent irreparable nervous system damage. Number 5. How is canine distemper treated? Veterinarians diagnose canine distemper through clinical appearance and laboratory testing. There is no cure for canine distemper infection. Treatment typically consists of supportive care and effort to prevent secondary infection like control vomiting, diarrhea and neurologic symptoms, and combat dehydration through administration of fluids. Dogs infected with canine distemper must be separated from other dog to minimize the risk of further infection. Number 6. How is canine distemper prevented? Vaccination is crucial in preventing canine distemper. A series of vaccination is administered to puppies to increase the likelihood of building immunity when the immune system has not yet fully matured. Avoid gaps in the immunization schedule and make sure distemper vaccinations are up to date. Avoid contact with infected animal and wildlife. Use cautions when socializing puppies or unvaccinated dogs at parks, puppy classes, obedience classes, doggy daycare and other places where dogs can congregate. Pet ferrets should be vaccinated against canine distemper using a USDA approved ferret vaccine. So yeah, if you think your dog has distemper, guys, do not panic. Immediately take them to the vet. They try their best to treat your dog with distemper by providing supportive care and preventing secondary infection by making sure that they have plenty of rest and fluids. So yeah. So guys, tell me in comments that any of your pup or dog has distemper. And thank you for watching my video.